Okay, let's move on towards the game day. We're gonna be able to move on towards qualifiers. Day one, last matchup is gonna be match for game one, first half of Axis versus FT. We're gonna be able to see Gardner Patient and Bomber, and of course the first officer against an opera singer with trump card detention. It's gonna be double tie turner with Gardner alongside with no bar or time Windows speed boost, and of course everyone else with Windows speed boost except for first officer with that tie turner there as well. Okay, let's see the spawn location. We're gonna be able to see Mini Blue here running a little bit down towards where again, sorry, my brain's lagging, down towards four stop. That's gonna be a drop down there immediately. Kakaka also, okay, we probably hooked a little bit too early there, but that wasn't that much of a bad hook. But even with that hook on mind, I don't think that's necessarily good, simply because of the fact that you don't really have anywhere else to go, and that's gonna be a normal hit immediately registered. That padded down wasn't the worst. Deciding not to get rid of it, and that was going to be a vault over there from Patient's point of view. Patient does have another window here to use though, so that's pretty nice. So we just have to keep in mind of all the windows and the pallets here to be played around. That's going to be another vault over. And hello Patient, we're going to be breaking a pallet with fast pallet breaking. That's going to be another vault over. And can we get the pallet? It's fine. Blink is going to be ready soon. We are going to be able to TP back, and of course that's going to be a terror shock down. That was a 180 and then 360 degree turn, apparently. Yeah, that was a 180 and then 360 degree turn. Overall for that, the terror shock in a nutshell for Opera Center just means that if you rescue now, she'll be at max presence, but from Survivor's point of view, we are going to be able to see the coffin there as well. We forced the pocket watch a little bit earlier than I expected, so as long as Kakaka here maintains distance, everything should be fine. Okay, we should be able to force the rescue here. There's no point for our opera singer to wait. Waiting is just buying way too much time. You might as well hit him early while the cipher machine isn't ready or waiting. That's gonna be a normal pitch. Nice. And there goes our patience. Didn't get a hit. Okay, didn't get a hit. That's gonna be another hit, and we missed a little bit. Okay, you know what, it still works. You know what? If it works out, then it works out. We're gonna run far away from the area. We do have teleport here though, so we still have to be very mindful of what we do. So with the teleport here on mind, that's gonna be an immediate change up. We're going to teleport over and then go straight towards two-story area. Sadly, the cipher machine here wasn't finished though, and we didn't really force out the blink, so yeah, there is also that too. We're just waiting. Okay, we vault over. There goes the invisibility immediately from Patient. Patient running straight towards Gaka here. Double pallet here to use. It depends on how long he can use these double pallets, but it seems like not for long. We don't have any items here remaining, but we're able to finish three cipher machines, starting the fourth one as well. Gardner seems like she's nearby, if I'm not wrong, because if Gardner's nearby, okay, no, Gardner's not nearby, thank God. If Gardner gets chased next, it's going to be a 3-man elimination. That's the worst part of it all. If Gardner gets chased, it's going to be a 3-man elimination because we don't have borrowed time here. Meanwhile, Tinnitus. Tinnitus did manage to pop out here as well. We did lose Tinnitus, but it doesn't matter. We're going to be looking for whoever's near this area, but it seems like the crouching scenario worked pretty well. We lost Embalmer, but Embalmer's actually on the outer side right now, so it seems like we did realize here too. Do we see Embalmer? Embalmer's right there. Ah, we don't see Embalmer. Okay. If we don't see Embalmer, everything should be fine. Shadow is going to be spotted out here though. Gardner being spotted is probably the worst case scenario, because with Gardner being spotted out here, if this was the case, Gardner shouldn't have appeared, is what I feel like. Because like, you might as well let Embalmer do his job. We didn't vault over during, okay. I felt like we could have vaulted over there, but we probably wasn't keeping track of the timing there from Shadow's side. So Gardner, quite a bit of a fatal mistake. Blink is not ready, but teleport is. Didn't get the hit there. That's fine. We're trying to catch up here immediately. Gardner, not fast enough, sadly. Just not fast enough here, sadly. That's going to be a pickup. Drop down and most likely teleportation out. First officer, cipher machine, cranium 75%. We do know where Yush is as well. We do see where Embalmer is, so we can kind of just force a rescue here. This looks like a four-man elimination here, as long as we can force a rescue. Okay, that's a lot. Okay, damn, that's a lot of shadows. Oh my god, that's a shadow army. Oh my god, that's an actual shadow or okay. Oh damn, That's an actual shadow or lmao. We TP back, that's gonna be a normal hit there. And with that in mind, we're gonna start up last cipher machine. Seems like first officer wants to do so, but Yeah, they're just too far away. You might as well go after. You might as well go after Embalmer here then and start slugging for endgame, is what I feel. Embalmer. We're trying to bait Embalmer. That's no hit, which is fine. And TP back here just a tiny bit. Do we see where First Officer is? We do. So that's going to be the first pocket watch there from First Officer side. And of course, with First Officer here on mind, shouldn't be able to get the second one, but he should be able to get a third one there, so that's no hit just yet. But it's a double down situation, so we can always take it. Ah, you. I mean, regardless or not, whether we give the terror shock there, I don't think we'll be able to see a four man. I don't think we're going to be able to see a three man endgame anyways. Maybe a two man endgame, but with that in mind, I First Officer will most likely be slugged. So with that in mind as well, no items from First Officer endgame. I don't think that changes any difference. Yosh, hello. Hello, my friend. That's going to be a bomber. No, pilot. Okay, that's still going to be a hit though. Let's graduate the four-man elimination here. Moving on. Okay, let's directly move on to our second half of game one. We're going to be able to see Kuga coming out as Opera Senior Trump Card Detention alongside with Blink. It's going to be a double tie turner here on both the Cordy and the Mercenary, except for the fact that Cordy also has Windows Speed Boost. And then, of course, Lawyer and Gardener, Windows Speed Boost on two of them here. Okay, let's move on towards the game then. It's going to be Kuga. We're going to spawn a little bit closely. Well, we're going to spawn in between Circus and Fourth Stop. Seems like Gardner is going to be first chase here. Tuna should at least guarantee us a 50-second containment. Worst comes to worst, Bubble pops just on time. Opera Senior gets a hit and, Gardner gets a blink down. But we'll have to see how this goes, though. That's going to be another pallet boost alongside with a window speed boost. Gardner is running really fast here. That's going to be the TP by Opera Singer. 18 second cooldown towards the teleportation. That means 18 seconds Gardner is basically from counter looping. Put the counter loops here on mind Gardner. We're currently trying to figure out where the red light is coming from, but we are going to be able to pick the window without the window speed boost. Need your reflex not ready just yet. Pilot here has also been picked up by the Gardner earlier on just to stall a little bit more time from the Opera Singer. But it seems like we should be able to rotate towards the double pallet window area here near Fourth Stop. That's going to be another double pallet window area in mind. And seems like we have an Insta bubble ready for next game. Now, overall, this containment is really bad from Axis Survivor side. Compared to the last game where it was like an almost 2-minute containment, this was basically 60-70 seconds. I mean, I'm not saying that it's bad, I'm just saying it's a bit worse compared to last game's containment. First chase was a little bit, but we're just gonna have to see what the survivor decides to do. They could potentially opt out for the sell here, because selling with a lawyer on the field is definitely much more worth it for a tie. But maybe sometimes double tie turner will also work here as well. That's gonna be a normal hit, normal rescue. Gardner currently on the run. Gardner could run towards the corner, or that can be an instant shield coming up as well. So the bubble is basically instant by this point. We're waiting around a window. I don't think there was a need to wait around that window, because you can't really win against that window. Like, you could potentially take the window, run towards this pallet over here and try to play pallet mind games, but I guess in that scenario, 40 seconds probably isn't enough. Probably just is not enough. We do see where Cordy is as well. Cordy with another tightener and of course with a gun. But if we decide to rescue here, preferably speaking, we don't want a double down situation. Stay put, I'm coming from the coordinator side. Cordy, in a nutshell, right? I genuinely do think she's going to sell. She could potentially gun an immediate rescue for a non-double down scenario, because coordinator can still definitely get hit. Seems like Cordy will be able to make it in here. Okay, Cordy should be able to make it in here pretty safely. We didn't see Cordy by the stairs, but we do the footprints right now. That's gonna be a lot of mind games there. We still see the we don't get a gun out. Okay, if we don't get a gun out, I think everything's fine. Garden just has to run somewhere very, very, very far away. And now the last three survivors just have to heal. Lawyer should be the one rotating away from this part of the map right now, and most likely, preferably here for Lawyer. Please, my friend, just go towards First Stop Cypher Machine. As long as Lawyer can make it towards First Stop Cypher Machine, that's all what is necessary. Because regardless of whoever gets their first kite here, whether it's Cordy or the Mercenary, that 55% cipher machine is going to be able to finish by both of them, especially with the fact that accelerated decoding has just started here as well. Now then, both coordinator and mercenary, we're going to go towards our separate ways. We're going to be see where the coordinator is right now. Cordy with no borrow time, but the good news for Cordy here is, right, the good news here for Cordy is the fact that she still has a gun. So like, maybe the rebound might not be for long, but a gun can be used as an extension for Tide Turner, because we don't have Tide Turner remaining here anymore. That's gonna be Lawyer next chase here immediately. That's gonna be a normal hit there as well. Mercenary trying to open up a new cipher machine. Lawyer rush you straight towards the window. We should be able to get a window and try to rotate. We cannot rotate Opera, so there's nothing you can do in this situation. That's gonna be a normal hit down as well. And Mercy should be on his way then. We decided to vault over the window. I guess whatever works for you. Now then, this doesn't look too grim for the survivors. Honestly, this doesn't look too grim for the survivors. If Nyang really gets targeted next, Mercy can definitely get a rescue before half. We need to keep that in mind. Mercenary can 100% get a rescue before half. Coordinator already rotating away here as well. Even if you're back, it doesn't matter much. Because with the TP back here on mine, Mercy is still going to be able to get the rescue here anyways. And if you don't TP back now, Lori's going to be get a lot of stuff for free. We got a gun. I'm surprised that didn't hit the wall. I'm genuinely surprised that didn't hit the wall. That's a really risky gun right there. But I guess Cordy is still up and running, which is good news. We have one pallet here to play mind games with, one pallet to play mind games with, but seems like we kind of feel the mind games there. Lawyer 20% decoding speed boost. This is currently new season as well, just to let everyone know. So Lawyer only has 50% decoding debuffs boost in our ranked games, but since this is during co-op, it's still 20% BW. It's gonna be mercenary triple elbow pad here. Not a single elbow pad used, by the way, coming in for the rescue. This is very, very, very beneficial for the survivor's point of view. We're currently 5 minutes in towards the game. Kuga trying to find the next nearest survivor. Very smooth controls, by the way. I definitely will not disagree, but is it enough? No. Because mercenary is going to be able to make it in towards the rescue once again without a single elbow pad, unless, you know, Opera Singer comes back, as we do here as well. Opera is, well, we could go for the full check. No, we can go for it before half rescue. It's doable. That's going to be a new meter rescue right there. That's going to be hit on two mercenary. But even if you hit Mercy here, it does not matter too much, because Mercy can still benefit from, oh, that's a hit. Mercy can still benefit from the borrow time. And we get a teleportation out. The Lawyer is not on tram, surprisingly. But Lawyer goes down here. Okay, Lawyer not on tram is a little bit annoying. But I guess since the cipher machine's at 93%, what we could potentially do here is we can have Lawyer and Mercenary force the cipher machine to be opened. Realistically speaking, that's probably the best way to do it right now. With 93% on hand right now, it's better for, like Mercy tanks normal hit, gets the rescue, both of them rush towards the last cipher machine. Like Mercy, if both Mercy and Lawyer do it, there's definitely a chance. But even with this in mind, since teleportation is now used, where Mercenary is a little mercenary first elbow pad coming in, mercenary second elbow pad in 2 seconds, 1 second, that's gonna be a normal hit, but it's okay. You have another elbow pad, you need to use this elbow pad right now. That's gonna be a meter rescue right there. We are going to have to look for the body block situation here for as much as we can. Mercenary on the ground, but we weren't able to get much there, which is a tad bit unfortunate. Kuga here seems like he's gonna be able to get a 4-man elimination here. We know where dungeon is, so we might as well chair. No, Cordy needs to go find a needle. If Cordy can find a needle, it'll be a little bit more different. Cordy currently looking for an item right now. Coordinator, Kuga has shown very, very, very strong prowess. Am I using that right? Well, I don't know if I'm using it properly, but he's showing very strong abilities here with the Opera Singer. Of course, us EU gang can never do this because we have yellow pin. Still a bit salty on that, by the way. Lol. But let's see here. 24% decoding. 24% decoding there on towards the coordinator. And Cordy might be spotted out here. Cordy might actually be spotted out here. She's gonna get found immediately. Sees with a footprint. Do we not see the footprint? Do we? Oh, we do. Okay, Kuga's just playing around. Okay, let's congratulate the 4-man elimination here coming from FT's Hunter site. Moving on straight towards game 2.